So let's have a look at the model we are going to create today. Let's begin. As you can see, there are two fish swimming in a semi-transparent tank. If you look at the details, there are quite few bugs, like the fish body and fin not connecting properly, the direction of the fins or stones floating a bit. At present, Claude cannot see objects as images through unity-mcp, so it's basically in a blind state. So it's currently not good at connecting things together precisely. It seems to be current limitation. With future updates, it might get the ability to check images, which might improve these issues. Let me briefly explain about the MCP protocol. The MCP protocol is a protocol that allows AI to use various tools. Specifically, the AI, in this case, we are using Claude from Anthropic on the left, can communicate with the MCP server in Unity to ask what tool it can use or make requests like, I understand, please add an object at this coordinates. It can make such requests. MCP was originally proposed by Anthropic, but it's an open protocol and anyone can implement the server. So there are many MCP server implementations for Unity, Blender, Aquarium, Brave, so many. However, many are not official but developed by individuals for personal use, so be careful with security. The unity-mcp we will introduce today is also one published by individual developer. MCP server we'll be using today, we'll be using Justin P. Barnett's unity-mcp. It's only been public for a few days, but already has over 700 stars, making it popular MCP server. There are other Unity MCP servers like Ardoy's Unity MCP, but Justin P. Barnett's Unity MCP has more momentum. And after trying both, I found this one works more reliably and it's easier to set up, so that's what I'll introduce. First, let's download Claude. Search for Claude download and download it for your OS. After downloading, launch Claude. Once you log in, you should see a screen where you can use Claude. And trace something. And that's complete the downloading Claude. Next, let's create Unity project. As noted in the Unity MCP instructions, use Unity version from March 2020 or later. Let's create project. I confirm it works with Universal 3D, but I think it should work with others too. You can name the project anything you want. Next, let's install the MCP server in our Unity project. Open the Unity project we just created, then go to Window, Package Manager, click on the MCP URL and select Add Package from Git URL. Then enter the URL and make sure to include .git at the end. It's important. After adding, we'll wait a while and the MCP server will be installed. If compilation succeeds, we are good. At this point, you might see a warning in the top right about invalid package dependencies, but this version mismatch doesn't seem to cause any problems currently, so we can ignore it. Now that we've prepared Claude and our Unity project, it's time to install unity-mcp. Unity-mcp needs to be downloaded locally. Some of you might not have Git, so let's just download it normally as zip file. Extract it. I'll place the downloaded unity-mcp repository in the document folder instead of downloads to prevent accidentally deleting it. To run unity-mcp locally, you need UV. UV is Python package manager that helps you download complex dependency packages when running Python code locally. On Windows, you can run it from PowerShell. After installing, let's confirm that UV has been properly downloaded. Now, let's add the MCP client to Claude. From setting to go developer, edit config, and open Claude desktop config.json. I'm opening it with VS Code, but you can use any editor. Then, set up unity-mcp to be included in mcp servers. And delete the others to avoid confusion. This looks good. Note that the second argument needs to be changed to the past where you downloaded the repository. I downloaded it to the documents folder earlier, so here it is, the downloaded repositories / Python path. Let's add this. In JSON, backslashes are invalid, but Windows can recognize forward slash as separators too, so fixing it this way makes the JSON. Now the setup is complete. After that, the changes haven't been applied yet, so let's close Claude. Confirm in Task Manager that application has Claude. Claude sometimes runs in the background, so end task to make sure Claude is completely killed. Then reopen it. Now go back to Setting, Developer, and opening it. Nice. If you see unity-mcp running, that means unity-mcp is working correctly. Let's finally start modeling. First, let's check if it's recognizing the project correctly. Using unity-mcp, please tell me the same information. By the way, Japanese is fine too. I'm inputting in English for the purpose of this video. When you execute it, you'll be asked for permission to run mcp commands. So I put allow for this chat is good, so you won't be asked for permission again during this chat. This is fine for our experiment since we are using a brand new Unity project, so there are no risk of object being messed up. But if we are working on project with multiple developers or for client, you might want to confirm each time. It executed successfully. So let's finally start modeling. Using unity-mcp, please model a fish tank with fish. Yes. We are being asked to allow the new create object command and for materials too. It's already creating things, but it seems it doesn't quite know how to handle transparent materials, so we'll need to supplement that by hand later. You can see it being edited in real time. Right now, it's failing to set transparency correctly, so you can see it. But if we look inside, we can see it's being modeled properly. You can see the objects increasing. Now, let's fix the semi-transparency. The problem, as you can see it in the inspector, is that the glass material's surface type is not set to transparent. So, let's ask Claude to fix it for us. The glass material and water material have the surface type set to opaque. I think it would be great if you could fix this, please. Will it work? No, it's not fixed. so I'll fix it manually. Click on the material. And set it to transparent. And this one to transparent too. There, it's done. How was it? My impression after connecting MCP is that while it can perfectly create objects from scratch, it's quite good for getting explanations from Claude when you get stuck. It doesn't seem to be a problem with MCP itself, so as AI gets smarter, we can expect even better results in the future. Thank you for watching.